So hi, sorry for the delay. Some technical glitch has come. Technology will be always better and works wonder only when there is really it works very well. We struggled hard. Sorry to all the viewers. So thank you, Professor Piyush and Amrita, for taking all the pain to make out these technology works very well. So today, really very much delighted and very happy. I came on live to talk about on the role of mental conditioning in overcoming mental blocks of athlete to give the. See, you know pretty well. The sports psychology is one of the most upcoming branch in sports medicine. Across the world, people are really working and talking. And I appreciate the PEFI initiative to give the awareness on various issues by the experts of the world and India. And also, I'm very happy that I am also become coordinating with this PEFI and giving my talk on these issues and sports psychology and mental conditioning. Yesterday also it was very fantastic lecture by Professor Kamath, and during the Professor Kamath talk there was a few questions came up, and Dr. Gurdeep Singh has raised a very interesting question, that why are Indian players at the fag end of the game are really suffering and to clear out the game. See, I read many of the mental conditioner books, and recently also I studied Paddy Hampton as an Indian T20 mental conditioner. He's a very good trainer as well as the mental conditioner, has expertise in the cricket game. And as per him, you know, it depends on the in which the people are brought up. India was always, in general in the wars, it is a very submissive in taking up the wars. And we need to learn to attack. It is in our DNA being submissive. Recently, India has done one surgical strike on the border. So I think from these onwards, the Indian players also start working against the submissive nature to the attacking nature. And also it is imbibed in our DNA to be submissive. And now we need to learn to attack. Then only I think our players start learning with the idea of striking back to the player. That is one area. And majority of the professionals yesterday keep messaging that how physical education is going to play in the role of in shaping the personality. I do agree. I keep talking about this, that physical education is supposed to be our major curriculum, part of the curriculum in Indian education system, start from the LKG to the university level. Recently, Professor Khanna also conducted an international conference on the sport culture in the universities. That is a fantastic idea, that we have to inculcate the physical education culture among the students in teaching the morals for the student, ethics of life, how one can face the life. Then only India can stop the suicides in the India by the teenagers or the students. So come back to our topic. There is a golden words given by recently by our most wanted player, the Dhoni, the captain of Indian cricket once upon a time. He said that there is a question, there was an interview, it published in the newspaper. People asked the question, how you can really so cool and how you really take up the balls. Dhoni with all the smiles told, no, I may appear, but you know, whenever I enter into the crease, the first 10 balls really creates a lot of fear, a lot of anxiety. I will be very careful in taking them. I able to experience that my heart really beats fast. So he said that mental condition coaches are very important. You know, it's not that only that whenever they get trouble, they need to be given support. But I always feel and think that the mental conditioners, a sports psychologist, we always accompany the players whenever there is a competition. That way it's really going to helpful. And also we know that the golden boy, Michael Phelps, He always claims wherever they that, you know, my success, one of the part is that sports psychologist always with them, guiding them, training them to visualize what is really going to happen. In Sydney 2000, there's a girl we call the Maria Mutola. She's a 4 times Olympian and got gold medal in running, 800 meters running. She also said that without mental conditioning, without preparing, without visualization, I never feel that my preparation is completed. So they're all trying to communicate and tell the importance of the sports psychology and mental conditioning. And also we know that sports psychology journey started in 1898. You know, first time Professor Norman Triplett first work on social and sports psychology. They have done some research in that. That is the starting of that. Then in 1995, 1925, Professor Coleman Griffith, university started a university course in University of Illinois. And then there's a between World War and it was that course was closed. Then 1960 Melbourne Olympics, they appointed sports psychologist. In 1960, after that, 1986 is the most prominent year in sports psychology has started working because American Psychological Association announced that sports psychology is one of the most important branches. Till 2020, across the world, even India also, coaches, physical education professionals, and also the players started talking about the sports psychology and mental conditioning. It's really going to helpful for the people. See, it is a very common thing that a player who really practices good, talent is good, coaching is also good, but some players, when in the zone, they're really not doing great. Then really it is a question arises. That why really the players when they are very good at technique, very good at practice, performance is also good, then when they are in the zone, why they are not able to perform very well. Really, it is very heartening. So whenever any player comes to us, even comes to me, we check few things. What is their anxiety levels? Is there any tension experienced? What are the pressures? And what are the uncontrolled thoughts are there, and is there any mental blocks? And how much automatic negative thoughts are popping up? Then question arises, if after assessing how you are going to make the player to give the best performance. So we check their belief system, we check their anxiety levels using the CSI and CSAT tests, and speaking to the parents, speaking to the coach, then we design a strategy how to help them out. So we know pretty well that any person, maybe in sports or any other professional, first we should make them understand that what is their belief system. Because belief is only the thing which can make any person to perform better and give his best in the career journey. So we'll check their limiting beliefs. What are the limiting beliefs that is controlling the person to give the best performance in the zone? So how the beliefs are formed, you all know that beliefs are formed because of the environment in the house, the stories they listened, and the films he could see, and also events which he experienced in the life. Lot of other things which can create the belief of the person. So if the belief is always trying to say, tell him that he is controlled, he's not able to perform, then we'll check out what are his perceptions. For his perception, what is evidence to say that, yes, this is this thing. How many times it is repeating. So for any person to make one particular belief, there is a simple equation to make you realize. Perceptions plus evidence plus time, and that gives you the belief. So any person has a belief, this kind of some beliefs. Maybe some people, you know, they get the lot of training, coaching and everything, still they believe that they may not perform. So then we have to ask them as a professional, I'll teach them how to redesign their belief system about themselves, because that goes to subconscious level and it settles them. Vikram Singh ji, why an athlete is unable to give the best while in the gym? That's what I am really trying to make you realize. First, any person who is good at practice, not able to perform better, first of all, we need to check his belief. We need to check what is the perceptions, why the perception is generated, and what is the evidence he is collected to tell him. So after checking, we should redesign the belief system. So that redefined belief system, definitely, sir, physical education, definitely push up. I'll definitely respond to the queries in the last lot of the session. To change that, first of all, you can tell that I am a good player. It sounds very simple. But when you talk to yourself, you are a good player, immediately your brain will search the evidences. How do you say to yourself a good player or effective player, or you can give the best? Then brain goes into the history, goes to the present, and try to collect all the evidences which are there in the life. Some competitions you performed very well, you coach appreciated, and in some national, international level also you give the best performance, you broke your own record, and these evidences it collects from your history and tell to your brain that yes, you are a good player because you have these evidences. So that's how the new belief will be formed. So there is a one example we'll say for anything, that if you can, how belief works on the human personality. See, you take one pumpkin when it's in a smaller growth situation, as it is growing, keep it in a cubicle box, leave it to that. After some time, week, 10 days, you open the box, the watermelon will get the same shape as a cube. Why? Because the cube walls are controlling the watermelon to shape itself into a spherical shape. So exactly the same way, the walls of the box did to the watermelon, our beliefs also do the same to us. That is the reason, the belief what you have that you are cannot perform, you cannot do it, this belief works like a wall to the watermelon. It is also trying to compress you, and it will make you that you cannot perform. That's how the belief system starts working out. So we need to redesign the belief system. So that's how the mental conditioner trying to challenge the belief system which are controlling the performance of a player, though the performance of the player is very good in the practice level. Then the success in the sports always goes with this belief system that he's good at coaching, he's good at technique, he's good at strategy, he's good at his performance, good at it himself, believing himself that he can perform and he can be successful. And this we say that it is a conditioning, and you know, competing the sports is 100% physical, 100% mental also. So many studies have shown many a times that games are really a mental play which supported with a physical exercise, then only it can make you become very, very effective. Mental conditioning means what? Mental conditioning is a process of training your mind to modify your thoughts, attitudes, beliefs, to accept the thinking patterns, tendencies, and mental states in order to optimize the positive thinking and ultimately optimize. And learning, you know, it is a completely dynamic and evergreen. And you must also train all the players to come out of the box thinking. And any player to perform better, we all need to know that they must be learn or taught what are their motivation levels. There are so many motivation theories are there. Out of that, few are very, very important for the sport persons. We say humanistic perspective of motivation, that is the Maslow theory. You know Maslow? Hierarchy of needs. Identify the physiological needs, identify identify the sociological needs, identify the self-esteem needs, identify the cognitive needs, identify then reach the special factualization. So that's how we all need to identify which motivation theory helps a player so that he can pick up and rise more. And another motivation theory, you know, achievement motivation and cognitive approach to the motivation, and that is attribution theory, and contemporary approach to the human motivation, that is self-determination theory. So this Maslow theory, theory of need attachment and achievement orientation, attribution theory and self-determination theory, SDT theory, and these are all helpful for a expert or a mental conditioner coach like us, help the player to get the intrinsic motivation, which can also couple with the extrinsic motivation with awards, rewards, money, status, situation. Internal and external, this intrinsic and extrinsic motivation coupled and work with the player, then they can excel and perform better. And some of the abilities we can really improve continuously working with a player. When mental conditioner coach is there, like effective goal setting of pressure, making a player to think like a champion, having great confidence in them, belief system to be redesigned, and also the personal excellence, and maintaining the consistent confidence, and making them get rid of the influence of the past failures and mistakes, and improving the ability to take and working under pressure, and improving the ability to focus on and develop effective daily mental conditioning outcomes routine. And what are the other things which can hamper the progress of the player? One is that majority of the players are very good at hiding their doubts. Some of the players think that if I ask the doubt to the coach, or their co-players may think something else. And also their vulnerabilities and insecurities still gnaw away at them from the inside. Fear of failure, fear of issues, fear of criticism, fear of competition. And these are all things can really make any player to become little less performer. Then our most interesting topic is that what is a mental block? Mental block, we can say that a psychological obstacle that prevents athletes from performing a particular skill. It means that performance anxiety sometimes will hold them to perform better. And because of this mental block, the physically cannot perform a movement or a motion that they demonstrated talent earlier. That is the surprising. Mental block, what happens is that player is very effective earlier. He was very good in competitions, even in practice. Some of the national, international also, he performed very well. But in some situations, suddenly a player is freezed, cannot perform, cannot go forward. He always looks stuck in a particular situation. So this situation will make the player and experiences the fear, and this conflict maybe comes in his mind because of the poor performance of the past. So this mental block definitely is a temporary and can surmountable if it is addressed properly. So a player, these experiences, if we can share with a sports psychologist or a mental conditioner coach, he can definitely help the player to perform better, to come out of this. And this definitely it is anxiety based and experiences the uncontrolled movement and disruption, extreme anxiety, fear, intrusive thought patterns, loss of control, and become panic because he is considered to be one of the most best performer, but suddenly he could not do it. So these are the things which can make a player to be started feeling as a failure. So some of the mental blocks experienced by the players, I'll tell you. Let's suppose baseball player. Most common baseball player experiences the mental block is that the throwing yips, YIPS, yips you. This is where the catcher or instance cannot throw the ball back to the pitcher consistently. Catcher arm tenses and freezes. Either ball goes in the dirt or even the head of the pitcher. This is the one of the popular mental block experienced by the baseball player. And gymnast and cheerleaders also prone to this mental block. Sometimes it builds over the time. Sometimes it happens all at once, but the gymnast just cannot force herself to complete the previously acquired skill, such as a back handspring. And another is a pole vaulter. Pole vaulters cannot put the pole down on their approach to the bar, which is called bailing. You know, this is very common. They keep practicing, but suddenly they're stuck and they cannot perform. These are the mental blocks you can experience. You can say that they all really experience this. So then these mental blocks, what they experience, major reason out, we'll say that high stress, perception of the degree of self-confidence and the mental toughness also matters this. Then the real challenge is that how to overcome from these mental blocks. See, when you teach the players go beyond, out of the box, we say, a formal thinking of the lateral thinking all help the players. See, any player comes with this who is a consistently performer, suddenly stop performing, will teach some lateral thinking. You know, 9-dot problem is very popular. 9-dot problem. If you go to the Google and start 9-dot problem, you will get the 9-dot problem. It is very simple. Condition is that 9 dots equally spaced in a square, and then you have to join these 9 dots with the 4 straight lines. There should not be any double line. Number one condition is 4 straight lines. Number two condition is that it should join all the 9 dots. Number three condition, it should not be double drawn. Number four condition is that you should not lift the pen while drawing. These are the 4 conditions you need to draw. It is very popular across the world. So when you started drawing, joining the 9 dots, you experience how you are blocked, how you put some extra condition that should not go beyond. So if you can see that, you'll see there are 3 or 4 possibilities are there for joining the dots. The best possibility is that join the dots whenever you join, go beyond the dots. Then you should come back, because that your territory is not the dots. You can allow to go. The condition is not given to you that you should not go beyond. So majority of the players experience this conditioned, preconceived opinions about themselves that you should not go beyond. So this is one way of looking at the solution. And other one best thing is that methods to overcome. There are 4 or 5 methods are there to come out the mental blocks. Therapies to overcome from the mental blocks. The one of the most possible and popular thing is EMDR, eye movement desensitization and reprocessing. This is one method. There is a recent research also come, and this is a one paper. You can see, and this is another paper and published on the recent journals 2016. They say that performance blocks in sport, recommendations for the treatment and implication for sports psychology. This is one. And preliminary evidence for the treatment of performance blocks in sports, the efficacy of the EMDR with the graded exposure. These are the two most important papers, and if you go to the Google, you will get the tons loads of them. I'm going to explain you what is EMDR. Other one is CBT, cognitive behavior therapy, relaxation, visualization, and part of that neural linguistic programming. These are the most important therapies which helps the sports players to come out from the mental blocks or performance blocks. And EMDR maybe a phased focused approach to treating traumatic and other symptoms of reconnecting the client in a safe and measured way. Actually, EMDR basically used for the PTSD, post trauma stress disorder. Then later they also started working for these mental blocks. It is also given fantastic results. And we are done with the NLP also, visualization technique. Majority of the professionals will be knowing that the NLP method, visualization method, is very, very useful, because majority of the players, they talk about the visualization. Maybe imagery, some people will talk. Imagery is visualizing only the particular situation, but NLP helps you to come out with the belief system which is controlling you, and the value system which you are traveling, the attitudes which you are not helpful for, be like a champion. NLP is much bigger than your imagery. And the EMDR therapy images self thoughts, emotions and body sensation associated with the trauma, allowing the natural healing powers of the brain to move toward adaptive resolution. So this is what EMDR will helpful to make you train a player to come out. And EMDR therapy also changes the maladaptive neural networks by connecting the traumatic memory with new information. What EMDR is doing, see, when you have experienced some traumatic experience in the game, you are considered the best player and you started performing, suddenly there is some mental block, some conflict inside, some mistakes which happen suddenly pop up and it hold you and you stop performing. And imagine how traumatic it is that you are supposed to perform in the zone, but suddenly your skill, your talent, your training, your coaching, everything stands still. Everything is you forgotten. Everything is not really in a position to help you to progress and go forward. Then really it is really a great disturbance for the player. So EMDR, what it does, it goes inside of the human. The training will help you to redesign your experiences of the past. It will desensitize from the traumatic experiences what you have, and it is showing continuously influence your thought process. Because of the traumatic experience, there is a maladaptive neuron connection experiences in the brain. So EMDR will make the maladaptive neural connection can redesign into a normal connection, which make you experiences. That is the EMDR speciality. It helps you to come out of the distressing thoughts and with new thoughts and new emotions, and embody awareness allows the frozen sensation in the body to resolve through the healing moments. And another important thing is that NLP. See, NLP is based on some presuppositions. That is, one is that most important, very powerful thing is that map is not the territory. And mind and body form a linked system. Have respect for other person's model of the world. And a choice is better than no choice. And we are always communicating. If what you are doing is not working, do something else. And the meaning of your communication is the response you get. These are the presuppositions of the NLP. See, I always suggest the coaches. Coaches always come with a complaint that, I keep on telling you to practice like this. He practices. Sometimes, when I don't see, immediately goes to his own natural method. I keep on telling many times, but he's not listening. And this is a general experience also in our life also. When you are at home, we keep telling to our children doesn't listen, they do what they want. Parents come with a complaint that I keep on telling them method, but they're not doing. But NLP says that if the same method is not following, change the method. And also other thing is that you are telling in X method, you are getting the same response for many number of times. Change the mode of communication, method of communication, so that you get a different response. So coaches always should learn this method NLP so that you can method of communication also can be changed so that they understood in different way and come out with their new method and new way of understanding. Another principle, the most powerful presupposition which is helpful for all the players, there is no failure, only feedback. See, you given one attempt in a particular game and sometimes suddenly you did not perform. And that is not a failure. If a brand is a failure, and after that, no player will come forward and start playing it. So what we need to say? We need to say that it is only feedback. What is the feedback? That in this particular time, particular way, you are unable to give the best at that particular moment. Take the feedback. What is the conditions which made you not to perform? Identify that conditions. Redesign them. Work out. Play, practice, take help from the coach, identify, get the video of your play and identify what are the mistakes you have done it and then learn them, practice them, practice and you lead the way successful. So any player, any powerful personalities in the world, they always say the same thing, practice, practice, practice. In other way around, repeat, repeat, repeat and that is the land you, that is going to land you in the success. Repeat, 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 become successful. Very simple. So that is the reason, make it a point. All the physical education teachers need to understand and learn. There is no failure, only feedback. And behind every behavior, there is a positive intention. Anything can be accomplished if the task is broken down into small enough steps. Sometimes the training looks very strong, very tough. It may create a feeling that, no, I cannot do it. But NLP says that any bigger task, any bigger training can be divided into the small works and definitely you can do it. It helps you. Once you accomplish a small task, immediately it motivates to do the next task. Next task will motivate other next task. Like that you can finish it. And these are some of the helpful presuppositions which can help you to become very, very effective so that you can perform better and also give you the best thing as a player and come out of the mental blocks. Another important thing is that our cricket team had one mental conditional coach, Paddy Hampton. He always says that work more on your strengths. If you have some weakness in the game also, don't concentrate on that. Work more on your strengths itself and that will help you to become very stronger and you become a successful player. And our hockey coach, Graham Reed says that every player has to fight a war between the doubt and belief. Whatever the doubts are there, you should put it in front of the coach and develop the belief in you that you will overcome that doubts and it makes, strengthen your skills and you become very effective. And I always promote any player comes to, in Hyderabad we have connected with the sports authority of Telangana and also we connect with some of the players, cricket, tennis, they keep coming, they ask me, we train. I have few case studies also. There is a one wrestler trained in Delhi with the camp. Then we have to understand that that fellow has a problem, like whenever he enter into the final match after winning 3-4 matches in the final, whenever he enter into the ring, a wrestler, he always experience that the body become tight and all the muscles cannot go forward, movements become very tough and he always have that the opponent is more powerful than him. He has a low self-esteem issues. So we work with the NLP neuro-linguistic program. We trained him visualization. After that, he started experiencing that the muscle become relaxed. And also he started experiencing that he has a good technique. He was trained under AG, effective people. And then he won the many matches after these exercises. So it is all how you train your beliefs. And also how you make yourself to be effective in giving your performance and also what kind of self-talk you indulge. This is also very powerful. See, the most important person in your life is yourself. So the anything when you indulge in self-talk, the self-talk, self-suggestions need to empower yourself as a player, as a person. So once you talk to yourself that this you are a powerful man, you are trained, you are practiced, your coach given endorsement, you won many matches, then that helps you that you become very powerful in dealing and handling that issues. So we always say that first to believe yourself and believe that you are the captain of your journey of life and as a professional, and take the help from the sports psychologist with the help of the coach yourself, sports psychologist, physiotherapist, and your family. As a team, you can emerge as very successful. And also, you all need to understand that every human being born with 10 multiple intelligence given by Professor Ward Gardner from the Harvard University. Any player is going very effective in the any game or athletes. We say that out of multiple 10 multiple intelligences, at least 3 are multiple intelligence, very, very effective with them. That is the reason he's reached that position. So identify what is the nature of intelligence you have. In general, every player have a body kinesthetic intelligence, supported with the spatial intelligence, supported with the interpersonal intelligence, supposed with the arithmetic logic intelligence. Combining all these four intelligence, then it makes you become excellent and make you become good. So I think the time is already 2 o'clock. I think I may stop because my slot is between